In this episode of FTD Facts, we'll be looking at the differences between the MiG-21 and the Mirage 3. The Mikoyan-Gurevich MiG-21 was designed by the Mikoyan-Gurevich Design Bureau in the Soviet Union. It was also nicknamed Balalaika. Now, the Mirage 3 is a family of single-seat, single-engine fighter aircraft that was developed and manufactured by the French aircraft company Dassault Aviation. So let's take a look at some of the differences and see how these two legendary aircraft compare side by side. Hey guys, this is Leroy Kenton here, and thanks for tuning in to another episode of FTD Facts. This is a channel where we love to share facts and information all about the different countries, cultures, and people from all around the world. Now, we have another military-themed episode here coming up right now, so don't forget to leave a like on this episode if you haven't done so already. And for all of you new FTD Facts viewers who are watching this and you haven't subscribed, what are you waiting for? Hit that subscribe button as well as that bell notification so you don't miss any future episodes like this. Okay, guys, so let's get into the nitty-gritty, into the meat and potatoes. Starting off with the MiG-21. So the full name for the MiG-21 is the Mikoyan-Gurevich MiG-21. And this aircraft also goes by the nickname the Fishbed. So the MiG-21 was the Soviet Union's first truly modern second-generation fighter jet. Testing for this aircraft began in the year 1956, and the first version entered into service between 1959 to 1960. And that one was the MiG-21F. Soviet designers developed a unique tailed delta configuration with a very thin delta wing. This gave the aircraft a lot of maneuverability and the ability to hit high speeds. The aircraft had good medium altitude performance, as well as it had a pretty adequate takeoff and landing capabilities. Although these earlier MiG-21s had advantages in cost, durability, and mid to high altitude performance, they also had disadvantages. For example, some of these disadvantages was it had a short range, it had less advanced avionics, and it had a poor view for both the front and the rear. As well as the type of armament was very inadequate. Now, the range problem was alleviated, but not eliminated completely, by adding saddle-type auxiliary fuel tanks. Avionics, including radars, were improved throughout the aircraft's career, as well as better armament was added, and also the structure of the aircraft itself was built up and strengthened. Now, later versions of the MiG-21, like Yugoslavia's version, they're still used in combat today. These aircraft were built from the year 1959 up until the year 1985, and the number built was 11,496. So that was a look at the MiG-21. Now, before I get into the Mirage 3, just letting you know that this episode of FTD Facts is brought to you by Grammarly.com. Grammarly is probably one of the best softwares for improving your written grammar skills. We use Grammarly all the time here at FTD Facts. Like, what would we do without it? With all the typing and research that I do on a daily basis, sometimes I'm completely way off. Thank you, Grammarly. The software is loaded with thousands of spelling and grammatical errors that you make, so it can pick them up when you make these errors, and it has the ability to prompt you to modify your sentence structure or even change the word after it's like, what the heck did you just type? Join the thousands of FTD Facts viewers who have already started using Grammarly.com. I'll have the link down below where you can install it for free, or you can purchase the upgrade for even more features. All right, guys, now let's take a look at the Mirage 3. So it was the first Western European combat aircraft to exceed Mach 2 in horizontal flight. Way back during the year 1952, the French government called for something specific, and this is what they wanted. They wanted a lightweight, all-weather interceptor. So the successors of the Mirage 3 prototype resulted in an order for 10 pre-production Mirage 3A's fighters. Although this was to be initially created as an interceptor, this batch had been ordered with the intention of using them to develop the type for additional roles as well. During October of 1958, that's when the aircraft achieved a top speed of Mach 2.2 during one of its test flights, thus becoming the first European European aircraft to exceed Mach 2 in level flight. The number of these built were 1,422. So when we look at the specs of these aircraft, for the MiG-21, the wingspan is 23 feet and 6 inches. It has a length of 47 feet and 7 inches, a height of 13 feet and 7 inches, and it weighs over 11,000 pounds. Now, the maximum speed of this aircraft is 1,385 miles per hour, or Mach 1.05. The service ceiling of the MiG-21 is 60 to 61,000 feet. And when we look at the armament of the MiG-21, it has one gun, which is the internal 23 millimeter Gryazev. Then there's a Shipunov GSH-23L autocannon with 200 rounds. It has the capacity of up to 2,000 kilograms of stores and provisions to carry a combinations of rockets, and those are the S-24s, as well as it can carry missiles like air-to-air missiles like the K-13, K-5, R-60, R-73, R-77, R-27, as well as air-to-surface missiles like the KH-66 Grom, the KH-25, and the KH-31. And for the bombs, it can carry a KAB-500KR TV guided bomb and four 500 kilogram bombs. Now, when we look at the specs for the Mirage 3, it has a span of 26.97 feet, its length is 49 feet, and it has a height of 14.76 feet. And now, the weight of this aircraft is 15,542 pounds. Its maximum speed that it can achieve is Mach 2.2, which is around 2,350 kilometers an hour. The Mirage 3 also has a ceiling of 55,776 feet. This aircraft also has a range of 1,550 kilometers. Now, looking at the armament. For guns, it can carry two 30mm DFA 552 cannon with 125 rounds per gun. The rockets that it can carry, well, it can carry two Matra JL-100 drop tank rocket packs, each with 1968mm SNEB rockets and 250 liters of fuel. The missiles that it can carry are two AIM-9 Sidewinder, and these are air-to-air missiles, or it can also carry two Matra R550 Magic AAMs plus one Matra R530 AAM. For the bombs, the Mirage 3 can carry 4,000 kilograms of payload on five external hardpoints, including a variety of bombs. So, where can you find these aircrafts? For the MiG-21, the primary users were the Soviet Air Force in history. Now, of course, it's no longer Soviet, it's Russia. Also, the Indian Air Forces, the Croatian Air Force, and the Romanian Air Force use the MiG-21s. But one thing to note is that India is the largest operator of MiG-21s. In 1964, the MiG-21 became the first supersonic fighter jet to enter service with the Indian Air Force. Since 1963, India has introduced more than 1,200 MiG fighters into their force. And as of 2019, 113 MiG-21s are known to be in operation in the Indian Air Force. So now, when we look at the Mirage 3, it was produced in large numbers for both the French Air Force as well as a large number of export customers. Some of the more prominent overseas operators of the Mirage 3 include Argentina, Australia, South Africa, Pakistan, and Israel, as well as a number of other nations. So when it comes to the MiG-21 and the Mirage 3, these are probably some of the greatest and most versatile fighter jets that have ever been developed in human history. These aircrafts, like when you take a look at them side by side, they are pretty much equal. So it would be extremely hard to tell which of these planes would win if you were to put them head to head in a dogfight. You know, a lot of that would depend on who's piloting the aircraft. And of course, you got to sprinkle in a little bit of luck. Who would win? It's really hard to tell. But let me know down below in the comment section. What aircraft do you think would win in a dogfight? The MiG-21 or the Mirage 3? Sound off down below. So that brings us to the end of this Differences Between episode. And before I go, just a reminder that this episode of FTD Facts is brought to you by Grammarly.com. I'll have the link down below where you can install Grammarly for free and really start to improve your written grammar skills. And if you love using Grammarly and want to continue to expand on its capabilities, you can purchase the upgrade. So that's it for me. My social media links are also down below. And I'll see all of you real soon in another episode. Hello everyone that's still watching this who loves learning. Here's some videos that I highly recommend if you love learning about the military. We have tons of videos about the military, like a lot. We also cover other topics here on FTD Facts, so don't forget to tune in every single day for more educational episodes. Okay guys, I'll see you soon.